Yo!
What's up?
This is Patrick.
I'm Jason.
And in this video, we're gonna show you how you can use the formatted table option in Power BI along with Microsoft Forms and Power Automate to do some automated email types of things. Stay tuned. If you find this for the very first time,
ouch.
Be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date from all the videos from both Adam and these guys. All right, Jason, thank you so much. Welcome to the cube.
Man, this is a really nice cube, man. My cube is not this nice.
And guess what? You're the first person to actually record in the cube. So welcome.
I will take it. This is awesome.
Yeah. All right. So, Jason, you have been telling me about this solution where you're using formatted tables, Power Automate, Microsoft Forms to send emails inside and outside the organization. But that's not all you do. Give us like a quick summary of Jason is, what Jason does.
So I'm the co-host of the Bifocal Show. So we talk about Power BI. It's a podcast. Faces for radio. That's what we are. Patrick decided that he wanted to bring all the funny.
So you were coming to town.
Hey, I'm in town. So you know, bring the funny looking guy into the cube. Let's see what we can talk about. So here we are. So we're working on this stuff together. We're going to be doing this community social hour, right? So I'm trying to set things up and get a form out there for the community to be able to say, hey, we want to come, right? We're going to do all this fun stuff. So how do you do that? Well, you can go off to third-party stuff or keep it inside the Microsoft stack. So, how do you like to do it, Patrick? So,
I'm not going to say it.
Can we go over to your laptop?
You got
to
do it the right way. Way. You know how we like to do a guy in the cube. Enough of this. You guys know how we like to do it at Guy Cube. Enough of all this talking. Let's do what, Jason?
Let's go over to your laptop.
Let's go over to my laptop.
We went ahead and created a Microsoft form, right? Something simple that people can just submit their answers to. And in order to do a great job of capturing this stuff, Forms does a good job, but we went ahead and created a flow action over in Power Automate, right? Oh. So that grabs all that stuff, shoves it into my favorite thing in the world, a SharePoint list. Simple, easy, beautiful.
You guys know I am a relational database, more specifically, a SQL Server guy. Why didn't you just put the data in SQL Server?
Well, SharePoint's faster and easier. Why would I bother? Okay. It's so simple.
Okay.
I can just quickly create a SharePoint list using Microsoft Lists, actually. I didn't even go with SharePoint Lists. I started with a Microsoft list, just happened to have backed it in a SharePoint site and Teams also. So I have all the goodness all together. I didn't need to go spin up a SQL Server or anything like that. Azure SQL, love Azure SQL, use it all the time. However, for this quick, simple, easy solution that I was doing on the weekend, end to end, 18 minutes.
So
18 minutes. And that would have taken me 18 minutes to spin up just
so is it safe to say
studio. Like, I'm not lazy, I'm just efficient.
All right.
Now let's take a look. So I have my SharePoint list, and one of the great things I can do, I can use SharePoint as a data source for a really fancy Power BI report. Look at that beautiful pie chart. So now we have our data set behind it though, what we need. One of the things I wanted to be able to do with this, I just wanted to create a simple table.
Yeah.
And in order to do that, I come over here, I'm gonna go grab the data set and go to formatted tables right here, formatted table. I don't need count, I just want name, email, and source. I have everything I need. I can go ahead and save this off, and this will now show up in my bifocal workspace. I just give it a quick name.
I did a video a while ago, so if you're not familiar with formatted tables, you should go check out that video. It's about, you know, using your data hub to find your data. But do I need premium capacity to create these formatted tables?
No, Patrick, you do not need premium capacity in order to use these formatted tables. These formatted tables are a pro feature, so you can go out off your data set and create that formatted table and be able to use it. Now, if I wanted to just be able to export and send this stuff off to you guys myself, I could just do that. But I'm highly efficient now that I'm on the CAT team, Patrick, and I am not gonna spend my time doing that. I wanna go ahead and I wanna automate this. Now, in order to do that though, I do require a premium feature, and I can use either premium capacity or premium per user.
Why can't you use subscriptions?
Because I didn't wanna create accounts for each of you in my tenant. So I wanna be able to just export this information on a weekly basis so that you and Adam, because I know you're gonna open the email, Patrick.
Every day.
Every single week. It's weekly, buddy.
Every week.
So Because I need premium, I decided, you know what, this wasn't quite as pretty, so I went ahead and I opened up Power BI Report Builder to create a paginated report, but I used that source. So this formatted table, I used as the source, and very quick and easy, I was able to just make this prettier.
So you were able to download the RDL file, open it up with Power BI Report Builder, make it pretty, like me.
Yeah, just like
make it pretty. But then when you publish it back, you have to publish it back to a premium. So like you said, since you're gonna use premium anyway, I might as well take advantage of all the premium capabilities.
Exactly. Right. Now the great thing is that I didn't actually have to download the RDL. I just went out and I connected with Report Builder directly to the existing RDL. And the cool thing about this, I do not have to save it the way I have to do with a PBIX file. Nice. Project. I saved it directly back to the service.
Nice.
It works beautifully. Now that I have my report, I actually want to go ahead and every week I want to export this file and I drop it into a document library as an Excel file, send it off to a SharePoint doc library. I already have one of those. And then once that Excel file hits into that document library, I go ahead and send off an email automatically.
Automagically.
It's beautiful. It works really, really nicely. It happens on schedule every week.
Wow. So if you don't know how to use Power Automate to do the download or the export of your Power BI report or paginated report, I actually created a video and you should go check out that video. I walk through it step by step by step. Once you're up to speed, then you can take advantage of all this goodness, all this greatness that Jason did for us. All right, guys, what do you think? Do you have any questions, any comments? You know what to do. Post it in the comments below. If your first time visiting the Guy in the Cube channel, hit that subscribe button. If you like my video, big thumbs up. As always, from Adam,
Jason,
and myself, thanks for watching. We'll see you in the next video.